everyone to the Honest Fashion Academy. My name is Justice. Okay, so in this video, I would like to show us different methods, different calculations that we can use to arrive at an accurate measurement to draft trousers. Okay, the video is not how to, it's not going to teach us how to draft a trouser, but it's going to show us some important areas, some vital areas that we need to put into consideration and the different ways we can use to arrive at what is fitting on each individual. Okay, so one thing I would like us to bear in mind is that all the methods might have differences in them as to the results. Okay, one might give us 10 inches, the other might give us 9.5, the other might give us 9.75, and so on. But just trust me, they all have a way of fitting the body. So all you have to do is to identify the one that suits you well and then stick to it. It's nothing bad if you try all the methods, then identify the one that works well for you. So let's get started. Okay, so here I have a picture of what the trouser looks like. Let's say this is the front part of the trouser. Okay, so at this line we have our waistline, at the upper part we have our waistline. Now one thing you need to know, that once you're making a trouser, your waistline can be anywhere. Okay, it should be where you want your trouser to sit. Now remember, we're not talking about high waist, we're not making a jumpsuit, we're making a pants, a trouser, something that fits on the waistline. Some people want their trouser to be below the waist, like a low waist. Some want it to be just normal below the navel, and some just want it to be just anywhere below the navel. Okay, so wherever you want your trouser to be, that's where you're going to measure, and that serves as your waist measurement, waist circumference. I hope you understand that. So now we're talking about, this is our hip line. We know where our hip is. We measure the widest part of our hip. This way, widest part of our hip. Okay. So let me say my own is 40. The widest part of my hip is 40. And just below the hip, we have our crotch line. Now this is the most important part of our crotch, of our trouser rather. This is the most important part. From the waistline to this line is the crotch length. Okay, from the waistline to there is the crotch length. You usually have it just below the hip line. Now we have a small extension here. After getting a box using our hip measurement, here we have crotch extension. This is a crotch extension. We're going to arrive at how to get this extension and how to get our crotch length. Now, to get the crotch length, there are different methods we can use to get our crotch length from waistline to this area below your hip. There are different methods to get. Number one of these methods is to divide your hip into four. Now, let's say my hip is 40. My hip is 40. 40 divided by 4, that will give me 10. So what am I going to do? From my waistline, I will measure 10 inches. And wherever the 10 stops, it becomes my crotch line. I'm just going to use it to form a box. You see, the crotch line is the same position with the hip line, okay, before the crotch extension. So from here to 10 inches, which is my hip, divide by 4, I can use that to get my crotch length. I hope that is taken. Okay, so the second method I want to show us is to sit on a surface, a flat surface. In this case, you need to tie something around your waistline where you want your trouser to be, so that when you sit on the surface, you're going to measure from that waistline to the surface you're sitting on. Let me show you how to do this. So here I tied something around my waist where I want the trouser to sit, and so I'm going to place my tape measure. And while sitting, make sure you're sitting erect. Don't just balance like this. Make sure you sit erect and place your tape where you have tied, where you want your trouser to sit, and measure down to the surface of the table or wherever you're sitting. Okay, so you can measure yourself, you can ask someone to measure you. So this is how the tape is going to be, and I'll pin it where it is touching on the surface. So when I raise it up, what I have is 10 inches. Okay, so having done that, we're going to look at another method to get our crotch length. Now the third method we're going to look at says that we should measure our outer seam, outer trouser seam. Now this is the outer seam, and this line is the inner seam. So we're going to measure what we have here from where our trouser sits down to the ankle, and then measure it from here, okay, not so in. You can ask someone to do this measurement for you. You can't do it by yourself. So measure this to where your ankle is. And here I measured 40 inches for the outer seam and 32 for the inner seam. So what we're going to do is 40 minus 32, and we have 8 inches. So you can see that this is not the same answer as the first two methods that we've experimented, right? So you need to try and see if this will fit you properly. If it does, then stick to it. Okay, so this is a third method that we're going to use to get our trouser crotch length. Okay, so we have a fourth method. I was actually looking at something. We have a fourth method. Now, what is our fourth method? The fourth method says that you need to pass your tape from your navel, cross it over down to your back waistline. Okay, so here we're placing our tape. But remember, don't make it tight, because your crotch is not supposed to be too fitted or too tight on you, so you can have a breathing space under. Okay, so just make it, but not too loose and not too tight, down to your back waistline, right? So once you've measured that, pin it there and know what you've gotten. And here I have 27. So what we're going to do is to divide 27 into 3. Whatever answer it gives us is what we're going to measure as our crotch length, from waistline to wherever it stops. So 27 divided by 3, it's going to give us 9. So our crotch length will be 9 inches. I hope that is taken. Is this making sense to you? Right, choose the one that works well for you. So we have a fifth method, and the fifth method is very simple. Now our fifth method is just going by the logic and going by some other suggestions. Now you're going to measure from your waist to your hip, to the widest part of your hip. It could be 7, it could be 8, it could be 9, it could be 10, depending on the length of the person and the size of the person. So here I think my widest part of the hip, from waist to the widest part of the hip, is 8.5, right? 8.5. Now usually you have your hip just 2 inches above your crotch length. So now that I have 8.5 as my hip length, from waist to hip, the widest part of my hip, 8.5 plus 2 inches, what is it going to give us? It's giving us 10.5, right? So 10.5 could serve as our crotch length. I hope you're getting something out of this. If the same from our crotch line will go up by 2 inches on the average to get our hip line, we can equally come down by 2 inches to get our crotch line. And that is how we arrive here. And so as you see, this is not far from this, not too far from this though, and the other measurement. So all you have to do is to look at the measurements, practice, know the one that fits you and your client, and just know that one method might not fit everybody. So when you look at the pressing, you can actually decide to use this method or that method. You can actually stick to one that works well for you. Okay, so this is about our crotch length. I hope you will not get confused anymore thinking of how to get your crotch length. By the time you exhaust all this method, you're going to arrive at something very wonderful. So the next part we're moving to is our crotch extension. How do we get our crotch extension? From this, this is our hip line, you get a crotch extension. How? Let me show you how. At our crotch extension, we should not forget that this box was gotten by our hip being divided by 4. So from this line, whatever we're adding is the crotch extension. Now there are so many ways you can get your crotch extension. Number one is to, on the average, add 2 inches from this line, 2 inches, okay? On the average, 2 inches can work for almost everybody, almost everybody. So number one method is just to add 2 inches here and then continue with what you're doing. I hope that is taking 2 inches. Okay, so number two method you can do is to measure round your thigh. This way, measure round your thigh. Okay, whatever you get, divide it by 2 and measure it on this from beginning of this line before you begin to slant from this line, the box, and then wherever it stops. It accommodates both the crotch line and the crotch extension. Now, if my thigh is 26, dividing 26 into 2, and that gives me 13, right? So I'm going to measure from this line, from the beginning of my measurement, down to where 13 stops. Now, I don't know if this will work for everyone, but it's a method and it works for some persons, so you can just give it a try and see how it comes out. That's number two method. So number three method is to divide quarter of our hip measurement. Okay, to multiply quarter of our hip measurement for the front by 0.15. Now the hip here is 40. 40 divided by 10, which is the quarter. 40 divided by 4, rather, will give us 10. So we are multiplying 10 by 0.15, and that gives us 1.5. This is for our front crotch extension. Quarter hip, 40 divided by 4, 10. 10 multiplied by 0.15 gives us 1.5. So here you can extend by 1.5. That's why I told you before that all the methods we have in drafting might not give us exactly the same measurement, the same answer. So identify the one that works for you and stick to it. If you're sewing for people, you can also try to experiment using different measurements from people and see how it comes up. This is for the front. So if you have to extend the crotch for the back, all you have to do is quarter hip, which is 10, multiplied by 0.45, and that gives us 4.5. So this is for the front and this is for the back. I hope someone is understanding something, right? So this is another method. Now we've done 1, 2, 3. What is the fourth method? What is the fourth method? Okay, I have the fourth method here. Now the fourth method is to divide our heap by 10. Okay, let's say our by 20 for the front and 10 for the back. Now this is our heap 40 for the circumference. 40 divided by 20 for the front, and that gives us 2. Okay, so for the front crotch, we are extending by 2. This is another method. 40 divided by 20, that is hip circumference divided by 20 will give us an answer, and we're adding it from this line and extending our crotch. Now for the back, what we're going to do is 40, which is our hip, divided by 10. What does it give us? And that gives us 4. Okay, so this is for the front crotch extension and this is for the back crotch extension. Remember that the back is always wider than the front because naturally the back is wider than the front. So this is the method we have to get our crotch length and our crotch extension. Did you understand something? Yes. Will you practice it? Please do. Do you have any question? Ask. Right? Let's continue. So we're going over to the knee. We're going over to the knee. How to get your knee measurement when you do not have you did not measure yourself or you did not take your measurement. I encourage people to take measurements. To take your measurements just from your waist down to your knee, right? Take your measurement. But whereby you did not take your measurement, there are methods you can use to get your knee length. And what are these methods? Keep watching. Okay, to get our knee length, the best method is to take your measurements from your waistline to where your knee is. Take your measurements. But whereby you were not able to take your measurements, number one method you could use is to measure from your waistline the full length of your trouser, divide it by 2, add 1 inch to it. Now, if you measure from here to here, and you have 30, divide 30 into 2, it gives you 15. 15 plus 1 becomes your knee length, where your knee is going to sit. This is just an example. Divide your full length by 2 plus 1. Now, number 2 method is to measure from your crotch line to the full length of your trouser, right? Divide it by 2. So let's say we measured from here to here. We are dividing it by 2. We're dividing by 2, don't mind. Okay, so let's assume it stops here. And then we add 2 inches to it. And this becomes our knee length. Okay, this is where our knee is going to sit. In the first instance, measure here, divide by 2, add 1 inch, measure it from your waist to where it stops. In this case, divide by 2, add 2 inches as you're coming up. Still the same thing, whether you measure from here or you measure from here, they are still the same. Okay, that's number 2 method. Now, number 3 method is to measure 12 inches from your crotch line to 12 inches. Wherever 12 inches stops, that becomes your knee length. Do we have another measurement? Right? So these are the 3 measurements that I I know that you can use to get your knee length. If you have any other one, put it in the comment section. I hope you've gotten something very valuable from this teaching, from these examples, from this lesson, whatever you may call it. Please do want to subscribe. Subscribe, like, comment, say something. Turn on the notification button. I have a gist for you. So, see you in the next video.